So how was school today?
Good.
You sure?
Yes.
No issues that we have to talk about?
No.
And your homework was fine?
I didn't do it yet.
How come?
I didn't have time to.
Okay. Well, when you get home, what's the first thing that you're going to do?
My homework. Okay.
Great. How is Mrs. McClellan?
Good. Can I have free time after homework?
Yeah. Be careful.
Okay. Ugh, it smells.
I think it's coming from the creek. We should get out of here.
I agree.
He's right. What he smells probably isn't good. It might even be chemicals from that old factory back there. Sometimes people do get exposed to chemicals in their environment. As you can imagine, hazardous chemicals can sometimes be harmful to people's health, and it takes a special group of people to figure out if those exposures are dangerous. A special group of people like the Agency for Toxic Substances and Disease Registry, or ATSDR. Hi, I'm Jennifer Freed from ATSDR. In the next few minutes, I'm going to introduce you to our agency. I'm going to explain what our agency does in communities like yours. Most importantly, I'm going to let you know what you can expect from ATSDR. There's a good chance you've never even heard of ATSDR before. ATSDR is a very small agency, part of the U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, the CDC. ATSDR's headquarters is located in Atlanta, Georgia, but we also have staff in the 10 regions across the country. We also have partnerships with many state health departments that help us address people's concerns about environmental exposures. Now that you know our name and where we work, you might be wondering what we do. In a nutshell, ATSDR's main job is to reduce your exposure to hazardous chemicals. How do we do that? Come along and I'll show you. ATSDR gets involved in communities where people might be exposed to hazardous chemicals in their environment. It could be something in the water, or the soil, or the air, or even something that we eat. Hazardous chemicals can be found both indoors and outdoors. As it turns out, there might even be something hazardous in this creek right here, and it's ATSDR's job to find out if it could harm people's health. One of the first things ATSDR does is visit the site. Once we arrive in a community, our first step is to talk to people who are concerned about hazardous chemicals and their environment. This is usually done by someone we call a health assessor. The next thing we look at is how people in a community might be exposed to hazardous chemicals in their environment. For example, have Tommy and his friends ever played in the creek when there is a strong smell? Once we know that people have been exposed to hazardous chemicals, we look at how that exposure might affect their health. We do this by studying data, a lot of data. In fact, that's what our health assessor is doing right now.
That's right, like you said. I'm in the process of studying the results of water samples collected from the creek to see if there's any chemicals in them, and if so, how much. It's basically what ATSDR does.
Most times, an ATSDR health assessor studies the data from samples taken in air, water, and soil in the community to see if people have had contact with unhealthy amounts of hazardous chemicals.
It's important to remember that ATSDR analyzes the data, but they don't collect the samples themselves in most cases. Either EPA or some other health agency will collect them. Sometimes there isn't enough data to make a call on. In that case, we might not be able to determine if hazardous exposures are occurring.
It's also important to remember that studying the data from samples of air, water, and soil takes time. It doesn't happen overnight. It can take a few weeks or even months to really analyze the data so that we provide the very best information about whether people are being exposed to hazardous chemicals. So it's been a while since our health assessor started studying the data of samples of creek water. Let's catch up with him to see what he's found.
Hello.
Hello. So what did you learn from the data?
Well,
We learned that there are some low levels of hazardous chemicals in the creek. They're high enough to cause odors in the community, but not high enough to pose any harm.
So there's no health hazard at the site?
That's correct.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome.
So the health assessor studied the data and came to the conclusion that the amount of chemicals in the creek was not high enough to cause any harm to people's health. And that's exactly what the health assessor is going to write in his report. Which brings us to the next step in the ATSDR process. After the health assessor has studied all the data, they usually write up a report that explains what they found and what it means. They may also make recommendations to the community and other health agencies about how they can reduce exposures to hazardous chemicals in the community. Once the health assessor has completed their report, they will talk to the community to explain what they found and what those findings mean. They will also answer any questions the community may have about the report, and this is done at a community meeting. ATSDR works very hard to answer any questions you might have about our reports. We want to make sure communities like yours understand everything they need to know about hazardous chemicals in their environment. So that's basically it. You have seen how our job is to help protect your community from exposures to hazardous chemicals. We have been doing this for over 30 years in communities all across the United States. ATSDR is looking forward to working with your community. If you have any questions about ATSDR, please do not hesitate to ask your health assessor or call 1-800-CDC-INFO. Thanks for joining us.